Hi guys, it's Cindy Lietz, your Polymer and Clay Tutor, and today in the PCT Test Lab, we are going to learn how to test plastics to see if they're compatible with polymer clay. Now, if you have some raw polymer clay and you want to store it somewhere, you can't just throw it into any old plastic container or plastic wrap because it might be incompatible. And the reason for that is that polymer clay is basically a plastic clay. So what's in it is plasticizers, oils, pigments, binders, fillers, all kinds of different chemicals and products in there, materials. And in its raw state, the plasticizers are kind of wet, if you want to call it that. They're available to leach out into whatever it's sitting in. So if whatever you have it sitting in is going to react with it, then you can run into all kinds of problems. If you store raw polymer clay in a container that is not compatible, it will leave it frosted, eat into it, do some really weird things. For example, I've got some polymer clay here that I just found in some craft supplies that my mom gave me, where she obviously used a plastic wrap that was not compatible with the polymer clay. The wrap itself feels all weird and kind of soft and sticky and weird feeling. And you can see the clay has been completely destroyed. It's been leached out and it's all broken and now it just needs to be thrown out. Here is a plastic wrap that was just fine with the polymer clay. This is the Glad Press and Seal, and I did some testing with it in a video previously, and you can check that out to learn more about it. But this clay is just fine. So what are you gonna do? Like, how are you gonna know which is the right kind of plastic? So if you can find out the number, the recycling number on the bottom of the container. So here, for example, is a pill bottle, and this is the recycling number here. It's in a little triangle, and this is the number 2 plastic. If you can find that number on the plastic, then you can find out what type of plastic it is. The types of plastic that are safe for polymer clay are the polyethylenes, which is number 1, number 2, and number 4. Those are all safe. So the number 1 plastics are these ones here, the food containers, water bottles, pop bottles, that kind of thing. Number 2 plastic, so those are polyethylene terephthalate. And there's a bunch of big names and crazy stuff here to learn. The number 2 plastic is also a polyethylene, but it's a high density polyethylene. It's safe for polymer clay. And number 4 plastic is a low density polyethylene. And these Ziploc bags are made with a number 4 polyethylene plastic. And so are a few other things, some of the plastic wraps and that kind of thing. Now, some of the plastics, there's also this container here. This lid is a number 4 plastic. Another number that is safe for polymer clay is the number 5, and that is a polypropylene. There's a lot of things in number 5 plastic. This Glad little container here is a number 5 plastic. The bottom part of this container is a number 5. And this drawer here is a number 5 plastic, and it's safe for polymer clay. And you can often see they're sort of a cloudy plastic usually, and they're usually flexible. Then there are a couple of other numbers that are not safe for polymer clay. So the number 3 is PVC. So that is actually polymer clay is a PVC clay. And the reason why it's not going to be compatible is because it's too similar. So a raw clay, it's got the same kind of plasticizers as a baked clay. It will want to bond with it, and so it sort of melts into it and that kind of thing. Another example of PVC is PVC pipe. Also vinyl. So vinyl flooring is a problem. It's not compatible. So if you drop polymer clay onto a vinyl floor, you want to get that picked up right away. Otherwise, it's going to eat into that and leave some marks on your floor. Also, a shower curtain, that type of vinyl is made of PVC plastic. Now, another plastic that's not compatible is number 6, and that is polystyrene. The weird thing about polystyrene is it looks different in different forms. So this is a number 6 polystyrene, and it looks flexible and kind of similar to some of the other plastics over there. This is also polystyrene. This is a hard, crunchy plastic that CD cases and things are made of. If you leave a piece of polymer clay sit on here for very long, depending on the brand of polymer clay, you'll get different etching and things happening to it. And I'm going to show you an example of that in a minute. But this is also polystyrene, but it's called expanded polystyrene. So it, what they've done is they've expanded it somehow. They've put air into it or some sort of chemical or something and fluffed it up and turned it into a foam. So don't leave polymer clay, liquid polymer clay, raw polymer clay sitting on a, one of these styrofoam plates, because it'll eat right through it. In fact, I had a comment from someone recently that had that very problem. Now, it starts getting kind of confusing when there is no writing on the box. Sometimes they don't put a symbol, they don't say anything at all. And that's the case here with this little container. In fact, well, I'll just do here. This one had a hard, crunchy bottom and a soft, flexible top. I have a whole bunch of these. My mom had them left over from a classroom, and I thought, well, I should better test them to see if they're going to be compatible with storing polymer clay or liquid clay into it. And so what I've done is I've made a little test batch here. Now, I did this more than a month ago. I took a little sample of each of the polymer clays that I have in my studio. I put some on the lid and some on the plastic, the inside, and we'll test them and see how they did. The brands that I used was Pardo, Fimo Classic, Soufflé, Primo, and I just realized this when I was looking at it. I accidentally put 2 samples of Pardo. For some reason, I really wanted to know about the Pardo. I also have PV Clay, Kato Clay, and Sarnet. And I've done the same ones on the inside, only one Pardo in that case. So let's just pop this lid off and take a look at those pieces and see if they did anything to the plastic. Because the labels are still there, I can remove them without, and I'll still know what was there. So I'm going to remove that. I don't see anything there from the Sarnet, so that's fine. The PV clay, there's nothing there. Kato clay. Oh, there's a little bit of something, but maybe I think that's just residue from the Kato. Yep, it hasn't eaten into the plastic at all. Bee's putty, let's try that one. Let's rub it off and see if it's clean. Yep, it's fine. It hasn't eaten into there. Let's try that Pardo. It's fine too. Fimo Classic. It's fine. Soufflé. That's fine. Primo. I'm not terribly surprised because I was pretty sure that this was number 5 plastic, just by the way it was looking and behaving. And Pardo again. If it's not the same, that would be crazy. Okay, so we can see that other than a little bit of residue from the clay, it hasn't eaten into the plastic. It's just fine. So that would be safe to store it in. This, on the other hand, I suspect we have a different problem because I could see it from the outside. Now, some of these, I stuck them to the inside just so that they wouldn't get all dirty and stuff. But I stuck them up a little higher. This is the Pardo. And you can see I had it sitting up here and it has slid down. And it's left a frosted spot here, which I cannot wipe off. So it ate into that. And also, let's see if I might need a little tool. I'll try to pull it off. It's gotten really, ugh. See that? It's all weird and sticky. It's eaten right into that. So obviously the Pardo is not compatible with this particular plastic, which is, this one is a number six, a polystyrene, I'm quite sure. Bee's putty, same thing. I stuck this up higher and it slid down. You can see some frosting there. I can scrape it. It is frosted. And yeah, it's stuck and weird. It's all gummy and really stuck there. So it's a problem as well. Here is the Sarnet. I can see some, it slid a little bit. I didn't stick it quite as high, but I can see it's going to cause a problem. Yeah, see all that plastic there is all stretching and gummy. Ew! And the clay just starts breaking apart because it's pulling the plasticizers out of it. All right, so let's try the ones on the bottom here. We've got Soufflé. That one's really etched straight in there. Can barely scrape it off. Ugh. All right, so let's move to Primo. As you can see, we can see that there, oh, now see, this one isn't as bad, so it must have a little bit different plasticizers in it, but it's still bonding with the plastic and leaving a problem there. Let's try the PV clay. Yeah, no, that's the same sort of problem. And it just turned the clay into dust. We'll try the Kato. Well, the Kato isn't as bad. It's still etched on there. It might clean off. It's not as bad. I'm actually surprised by that. Okay, so what is this one? This is the Fimo Classic, I believe. Yeah, Fimo. Oh, look at that one. It's just pulling the plastic right off of there. It really is on there bad. It's all gummy. And see, this is stretching like it is eating in there bad. And what do we got left? Oh, that's it. So as you can see, each of the different brands were a little bit different. I was surprised by the Kato actually, because it has such a vinyl smell to it. I would have figured it was going to be the worst one, but you never quite know what's in those clays because each of the formula is a little bit different and it will react with the different plastics. So make sure you are testing if you do not know which type of plastic your container or your plastic wrap is made of. All right, so just to recap, the safe plastics, if you do know the number of, is number one, number two, number four, and number five. And the not safe ones are number three and number six. There is a number seven category. It's called other. And the problem with the other is they throw a whole bunch of different types of plastic in that other. One of the plastics is acrylic. Acrylic is safe, but there's a bunch of other ones like nylon and Teflon and a bunch of other plastics that may or may not be safe. So seven is an iffy category. I wouldn't count on that one at all. If you see something with a seven on it, make sure to test it for sure. So I hope that was helpful for you. If it was, do let us know if you like this video. And don't forget to subscribe and press the like button and share this video if you found it helpful. And if you've got information that you would like to learn more about that I don't have a video on, then make sure to leave suggestions below, whether it's something you would like me to test, a book you'd like me to review, a technique you'd like me to show you how to do, whatever it is that you need to learn about polymer clay. Leave those in the comment section below. All right, so we'll see you next time, and bye for now.